guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm just doing an update video on the A-level Classical Civilisation videos that I've been making. So, as most of you will be know, I make classics videos with studying imperial image, Greek religion, the Aeneid and the Odyssey. So I just want to preface this video for people who just want to get the whole message out of the way. I won't be making any more of those videos, so I'm very sorry to future students who weren't taking their A-levels this year or their GCSEs or whatever because of the whole coronavirus situation, unfortunately. So this video is just going to be about that, and yeah, it's just going to be a montage of me and my survival world. So when the news came out that we were not going to do any exams, we all felt pretty defeated, pretty upset, which is strange because we all felt like Hermione Granger, who had just been told that we weren't going to do any exams and there was no homework and stuff like that. But it genuinely was like that, and we were like, what are you talking about? We're not going to do any exams. How are we going to get into uni? How are we going to do our apprenticeships? How are we going to, you know, forge our futures from our college work? And Ofcall, who are at the head of the exam boards, they said, okay, don't worry, we'll figure it out. And they took their time figuring it out. They did figure it out. And what happened was they released a list onto gov.uk website that laid out how exactly they were going to do that. How were they going to calculate our grades without an exam? Now, they are actually giving the opportunity to retake an exam in September if you don't think that the grade you got is fair, or you deserved better, or you think that you can do better, which is fair enough, because I think that's going to be the case for a lot of people, but I don't think a lot of people are going to retake that that exam, simply because we'd have to revise the whole of spring and summer and into winter, and it's not going to be very fun for anyone, really. It's just a lot more work, really, than it's probably worth. So they, in this number of documents that they put onto gov.uk, one of them was a message to students, and this document laid out exactly how they were going to calculate our grades. So it put a lot of emphasis on teacher assessment. So I'm going to assume, because I haven't done much research into this, that it's going to be the teacher that you that took you for that subject. As of recording this, I'm still doing my BTEC coursework. I don't think the message actually mentioned anything about that, BTECs, but I'm doing it anyway. We were told to anyway, and it gives me something to do during quarantine. So, just get it all together. And then it said stuff like classwork, bookwork, non-exam assessment, previous exams, yada yada. So it was all just prior attainment stuff like that. And everyone, yeah, cool. You know, what about confirmation bias? What about this? Blah blah blah. And Ofcall haven't released anything. So, but apparently that's just how it's going to work. If you had a bad working relationship with your teacher, then good luck. This is why you should respect teachers, basically, in my opinion. But anyway, before any of that was released, we were doing online classes, as so many people are doing. And once Ofcall said, yeah, you know, none of this is going to matter, I was like, oh, well, none of this does matter then. And I stopped attending class. I mean, I didn't really attend in the first place. we all sort of got kind of depressed. It was like a really rough time for us. It was quite heavy on our conscience. We were under the impression that we were going to be given our freedom soon after exams, or going to uni or starting our new lives. I'm not personally going to uni. So I now have my whole life ahead of me, and I didn't expect it to just be now, you know. It's not often that when someone says they're giving you their freedom, they mean now. So it came very early. Having your life suddenly just start is, it's a very strange feeling. It's a once in a lifetime feeling, quite literally, coming out of the education system. But yeah, I mean, it was rough. So a lot of us felt defeated. We felt as though 2 years of work had not mattered. 2 years of work down the drain, basically. What was the point in doing any of it? And really, for me, the whole point, the whole time, was the friends we made along the way. And that sounds really cheesy, and we made memes about it and stuff like that, but it really is the friends that we made along the way that made the whole difference to me. So actually, concerning the real life situation, right now, 14,500 people are dead. And that's a really strong, horrible number. But unfortunately, it's true. The last time I checked, literally just a couple hours ago, 14,500 people had been reported dead, and they suspect more because of, you know, nursing homes are being infected, and people are dying at home, not reporting it, and stuff like that. So unfortunately, that is happening. So the quarantine has taken its toll, I would say. We're a month in, and people are really disheartened. It's a struggle, even for me. The biggest meme lord out there, as I'm known as. But it's not pleasant having your just the choice to be able to go outside being taken away. I personally don't really go outside that much, despite being an extrovert, but the fact is, you'd like that choice. And even like me, if you don't go outside that much, just the choice being taken away is, or even restricted, it's very eye-opening. I used to spend a lot of time inside anyway, too much time, one could say. The fact of the situation is, the mental health is declining rapidly. The nation is having the whole world right now is having a crisis, a mental health crisis, a disease crisis, a virus crisis, literally just a crisis as a whole, concerning everything, because once you change one aspect of life, everything else has to change as well. Now, concerning the videos I've been making, like I say, there won't be any more. But concerning the world that it was created in, the title of that world was called Grove when I first created it. And as of the moment, it's actually deleted. I have a backup of it, of its last update. It still has everything. In fact, it has more than you guys have seen in the videos, much more. I made the sets for the rest of the Odyssey, the rest of the Aeneid, and I've just begun on Greek religion. I was making the Olympic arena. I was making temples of Zeus, temples of Hephaestus, using photos from Greece that I'd taken when we went there. as reference. But the fact is that's just not going to happen. And like I say, I have a backup of that video. So if anyone who uses a modded Minecraft wants to have a look at it, I have the save for it still. I have the file on my desktop. Or in future, if any future classic students or history students want to use it, then it will be there for them. Or if you want to create your own version of it, you know. It'll be the end, basically. So basically the message is now, is to stay safe, stay inside, you know. Go on your daily exercise, you know, cycle down to the lakes or, you know, take your dog out for a walk or, you know, sunbathe in your own garden or, you know, have a barbecue in your own garden. Keep yourself occupied. I haven't come back to Minecraft for a long time, but this is the first time in a while that I've enjoyed survival and not cheated. So, it's been a wild ride, but stay safe, guys, and have a great quarantine.